Okay, so we are on to an album that literally changed the face of music. Nirvana's Nevermind. Ladies and gents in Cyberland, coming back with another album review, and this time we're on to Nirvana's second album. Nevermind. So, as I had stated with Bleach, the first Nirvana album I actually ever heard was In Utero. And at some point, I decided to go pick up Nevermind. Didn't even listen to any tracks, because at the time, we didn't have things where you could sample music like where it is now. You can listen to all tracks before you buy it. And the minute I put it on, I heard a little, like a riff, and then, of course, it smells like Teen Spirit. And I was completely blown away. I had never heard anything like it before. The lyrics were different. The music was different. Everything about that song was different. I had no idea how big that song was, though, because when I finally got into it, the band had already ended. And I, for a couple months, I did not put down that album. It was something that was constantly in my rotation for track one to track 12, which, you know, if you have the original, it didn't have all the deluxe extra stuff. And then I did some digging, and I started going into the history of the band and finding out, you know, how everything ended up the way it did, and how we got Foo Fighters from Nirvana, and why, and I'll talk about that later. But overall, the album is a masterpiece. It's a classic piece of work, stands the test of time, and it changed the way music was being made, because before that, it was always like rock bands had to dress a certain way, they had to act a certain way, they couldn't just be regular people, they had to be like bigger than normal people, like they do things better, and they don't. They really didn't. With Nirvana in this album, there was this whole backlash to say that you have to live life to the fullest, you have to spend money, you have to drive the fanciest cars, you have to do all these things, when in fact, that doesn't have to be everybody. You can be married. You can not cheat on your wife. You can be a parent and live at home and do normal things like everybody else. You just happen to make music that a lot of people love. It doesn't have to be, you know, because outside of Metallica, I'm not too much of a big fan of the 80s music bands, because I kind of felt like this shit was over the top and just outright ridiculous, to where the music was in one category, but the performances of the music was just downright outlandish, you know? The heels, the spandex, the fucking makeup and shit, it was just ridiculous. And it just seemed like it got oversaturated, and it just got worse and worse and worse. And Metallica, they were one of the bands that didn't fit that, but the media was trying to do everything they can to keep from that band blowing up, because then, if that band blew up, the record labels were going to have to change their approach, and they were like, why change it if we don't have to? So they kind of did everything they could to kind of try to keep Metallica from getting bigger through any way they could, trying to say, your song's too long, can't play on the radio, or this. It was always some bullshit. And, you know, they got big through the tours. That's how their music got out there, because at one point, you know, at a certain point, the media can no longer ignore them. They had no choice but to embrace it. They had to. But with Nirvana, because the songs were a lot more simplistic, and because these guys bought clothes where I would buy clothes or other people would buy clothes, they ate the same food that most of us would eat. They eat at In-N-Out. They would eat at Sizzler. They would eat at Lucille's or Roscoe's Chicken Waffles. They would go to Carl's Jr. They would buy toys like I would buy toys. They played video games like I play video games. They felt so more normal than the rock stars of the 80s. Like, oh, 80s, they just drink and hang out with chicks. I can't do that. Well, these guys, they play video games. Well, I can play video games. So it felt more normal. And it felt like these guys were just, you know, they just made music to that was a part of it. So they spoke to the Generation X and, you know, the 90s people because of how they carried themselves. And the music, you know, because of that, people gravitated towards the music because it was something different. As I got through Bleach, I'm sorry, as I got through In Bloom and Come As You Are and Breathe and Lithium, and, you know, for a long time I didn't really care for Polly until I got older, but, you know, that's the territory of the Pissings and Stay Away and, you know, Something in the Way. And just overall, the whole album, it was just something different for me that, you know, to this day, it's just very special. It's not, you know, Nirvana's not my favorite band, but the album and In Utero, they're very special to me because they opened a door for me to listen to more bands that had something in common, you know, like Soundgarden and even Foo Fighters, you know, and Pearl Jam and Stone Temple Pilots, you know, these, you know, Nirvana, Nevermind opened my palate to be more open to those bands too. So that was a good thing. My rating for the album, 10 out of 10, yes, sir, that is it. Top 5 tracks, Smells Like Teen Spirit, In Bloom, Come As You Are, Territory, Pissings, and Draining. Honorable mention, Something in the Way. And Stay Away. Because it was hard to pick my 5. I knew my first 3, but the last 2 was like, eh. But, you know, it is what it is. If you've never listened to the album, I don't know why you haven't. I don't know what your excuse is, but it's definitely worth a listen. You may not be a big fan of it like I am or other people are, but it's definitely worth a listen. Yeah, so with that being said, let's cue music.